Come on, Ms. D. A deal's a deal.
All right. All right.
Yeah. Denifield House?
Well, I rented.
All I know is Denifield. Last house on the road.
Uh-huh.
Right there. Thank you.
You trouble.
Thanks. Christmas present.
Yeah. I guess. You say so. Hmm. Well, well, well. Who's sending me a Christmas present, I wonder?
Might as well open it and find out.
Beloved landlady. She's got clothes on. Too bad. My darling passed through Paris, found portrait finished, and told Philip to send it to you. Sent it on. All my love. Maybe it's not meant for me after all.
Hello, Katherine Delafield.
To Scorpio. Now, I am
absolutely underwhelmed. You've certainly given me no evidence that you cared. Unless, of course, you do this for all your tenants.
What are you talking about?
Don't tell me. I guess it must have slipped your mind.
Wait, now, let's start over, all right? Good morning. This is Katherine. Listen, I'm busy. Why are you calling me?
It's about this portrait of you.
Let's start over, shall we? Tell me about this paint picture.
Painting? Do you deny, true or false, this is a reasonable expression of your suppressed feelings towards me?
This has nothing to do with you. It's for me.
Well, anybody that's even partially blind can figure that out.
Oh, this is a work of art.
Good, then you won't mind working it out of here, because I've got enough of your junk here, what with this piano and all.
It goes up on the wall. It doesn't take up space.
Your wall, not mine.
This is my wall. This is my house.
Our wall, currently in my possession. But why don't you take this
with
you?
No,
fit in the car.
Put this down. Put it down. Now, listen. I need to look at this when I take a break from practicing. It really soothes me.
Ooh, narcissistic little piece, aren't we? Look, there's some more of your goodies over here. Just put it against me. Somebody sent these in the other day. Here we go. I guess they weren't feeling well.
They're very lovely, thank you.
Hi, hello, sweetheart.
Hello, Daddy. Who's this?
Well, this is Katherine Delafield. Katherine,
hello.
This is my daughter, Robin.
Hello.
Kathy's the lady that goes with the piano.
Oh, so that's why you wanted me over here today. She's going to give me piano lessons, right?
Well, not exactly.
Nice to see you again, Miss Delafield.
Hi. Again?
Yes, we met at the Quartermain, the wedding rehearsal, remember?
Oh, yeah.
I'm terribly sorry. I've forgotten your name.
Oh, I'm Anna Lavery. This is my husband, Duke.
Hello.
Very nice to meet you. It's Duke's Club, right?
Well, if you like the place, I haven't been there too long.
I really do.
Well, look, as long as you're all getting along so well, I've got to get to the office before Bobby's hearing this afternoon.
All right, well, you tell Bobby we're on our way.
Right, well, ta-ta.
Bye-bye now.
Bye-bye, Daddy.
Bye-bye, Dom.
Drive carefully, look.
Yeah.
Mommy, Mrs. Shelfield's going to give me piano lessons. Isn't that great?
Oh. Well, sweetheart, Miss Delafield may be very busy. She may not have time to do that.
Well,
think I can do that? Okay, Robin. The reason why your father didn't tell you about these lessons is because I told him that no one is to play this piano except for me. Mm-hmm. But if you all can keep a secret from Robert...
Oh, I love secrets.
Then you and I will secretly begin practicing, and we'll practice through the holidays and have a nice surprise for Robert by the time we start school again.
How would that be?
Well, that's very nice of you.
Well, we could ask. We can get you piano lessons on our own.
Oh, no. I really want to do this. Please. We could start today, even.
Oh, please, Mommy.
Thank you. That would be very nice. That's yes.
Very, very kind of you, Miss Stafford. Thank you.
Oh, my pleasure.
Thank you.
Well, we're going to have to go now. We have to get back into town.
All right.
Okay. Bye, Mommy.
Bye, sweetheart.
Yeah.
I love you too. Now, you'll be good for Miss Delafield.
Okay.
Yes, you behave yourself. You do have it.
Okay.
Miss Delafield told you to do. You
I will.
It. Be good.
Right. Okay. Mom,
thank
bye-bye.
You. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Bye, Lynn. I'll see you later, alligator.
Yes, goodbye.
Be good now.
Bye.
Why don't you help me move this painting? And you and I have got a lot of work to do.
Okay, this one right here?
Yep. Wasn't terrible. You're making real progress.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I think it's time for a play break.
That sounds great.
Hey, baby, you earned these cookies and milk the hard way. Now take some of these, sweetheart, and go send it out some steam.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay.
But can I take the whole plate?
Oh, just three. Okay.
Okay.
Stay warm now.
Okay. I will just put
there you go.
Hey, chum, you're pretty good for somebody that hasn't taught piano before.
Thank you. Oh, such a kind.
Well, it's not jazz scat, but it's cool anyway.
Thank you.
What are you charging Noah?
Well, since I am just getting started, I have a special deal for today. Will you help me hang my picture?
Yep. Right price.
Oh,
and I just
good.
Saw a hammer and hooks in the broom closet.
Oh, great. Great. Thank you.
Oh, that looks beautiful. Even much better on the wall.
Oh, I kind of like it.
Well, it's a very groovy picture of a very groovy lady.
Are you ready to get back to some practicing?
I guess so.
Oh, we must think more positively. Come on. Try to enjoy the piano. It's supposed to be fun. Now, sit straight so you don't get tired.
Okay.
Now, let's start it again from the top, okay?
Okay, right here?
Yes.
Okay.
Bad day for her.
Hey, I finished it. You got them faster now.
Oh, no, it'll get faster with practice. Now, we'll practice real hard, won't we?
Yeah, I bet you Daddy will be surprised when he hears us.
Yes, but only if you and I and Olin can keep it a secret.
Don't worry.
Me too. You too.
Okay, let's try it one more time.
One, two, three, four.
Hi.
Yeah. Excuse me.
Oh, thank you.
It's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard of.
What does this Lucy person do? Does she stay up all night dreaming up new ways to damage people's lives?
Yeah. I appreciate
well, I'm doing.
That.
You're well.
No, I know you have so much to
do. Sure, it's okay. Don't you worry. We'll be here for you.
What is the matter with you trying to use this child as a weapon?
Well, you're not going to be able to stop me, Bobby. What are you going to do? You're going to stick your little lever boy.
Stop fighting in front of the child. I won't have it. How's everybody? Did you talk to Amanda?
Yes.
Is she coming?
Well, she was a lot more friendly, and she said she might make it if her lunch didn't run too long.
Great, if she doesn't show up, they're going to have us for lunch.
And Judge Wilder is ready to start now. Step inside.
Robert's not here yet. Oh, he'll be here tonight.
Big son.
Okay.
Visitors and friends, please sit in the back. You with the minor child also, please.
Okay.
Mrs. Jones, Mrs. Myers, sit here facing the judge.
Clerk, are all the summoned parties present?
Yes, Your Honor.
Mrs. Keith is a social caseworker for the county. She will take charge of the minor child, Barbara Jean Jones.
Oh, no. I mean, couldn't I just hold her?
I'm afraid not, Mrs.
Simpson, Charlene Simpson. I'll take care of her.
Mrs. Keith. Mrs. Keith is well trained. She'll do fine with the child. If she needs your help, she'll let you know. There's nothing pleasant about these proceedings. They stem, of course, from Dr. Anthony Jones's unusual and unexpectedly severe illness. His incapacity requires that measures be taken to provide for the temporary custody of his infant child. There is a dispute as to who could best provide such custody. This hearing is an informal matter between the concerned claimants themselves. So we're meeting as if in my chambers, and there need be no attorneys present. However, I do see Mr. Scott Baldwin here.
Your Honor, I'm here just as a citizen, character witness, that's all.
Very well. A divorce action filed by Dr. Jones against Lucy Jones and disputes arising from such action remain unsettled. Mrs. Jones, anything else in dispute?
Well, no, not anything in the property, Your Honor. You see, Tony and I reached an agreement, but he collapsed before he could sign it.
Your Honor, since this is informal, may I comment on that agreement?
That's why we're here.
The agreement that Tony intended to sign very specifically provides that Lucy Cole Jones give up all rights of custody to Barbara Jean.
Your Honor, that is what is in dispute.
That's baloney. You agreed to give her up to get us money.
Mrs. Meyer, may I caution you against any further emotional outbursts?
I'm sorry, Your Honor.
Mrs. Meyer, what is your relationship to Dr. Jones and his daughter?
Well, professionally, I've worked with Dr. Jones at General Hospital for many years, and we're very close personal friends.
But you're not related either by blood or by marriage.
Well, no. BJ's named after me, though. I'm very close to the family.
Bobby, you are not a blood relation to BJ. I apologize, Your Honor. I'm sorry. Well, is this the right place? Oh, there you are, Lucy. Oh, Harold, I'm sorry I was late, but it was unavoidable.
Don't think a thing about it, Amanda. Do you have an interest in this case?
Oh, yes. I'm here to testify for my dear, good friend, Lucy Jones.
Good. Come on in. I know time is short. Why don't we start with you, if you're ready?
Fine. Thank you, Harold. I should call you Your Honor, shouldn't I?
Lucy's work at the Tanya Jones Daycare Center has been a triumph of organization. Well, she's handled the business problems, the fundraising, the hiring and the firing, and at the same time, she's never lost sight of the real purpose of the center, which is sympathetic care of children.
Would you consider Lucy Jones to be a fit and caring mother?
Well, I'd trust her with my grandchildren without a moment's hesitation.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Barrington. You're excused.
Thank you, Harold. Your Honor.
Mr. Baldwin, would you care to come up here and give me your views?
Yes, sir.
Welcome, Commissioner Scorpio. You here on this case?
Yes, Your Honor.
Good. We'll get to you in a moment.
Thank you.
As we worked on legal aspects for the daycare center, Mrs. Jones was always concerned about BJ. Her well-being, you know, she always wanted to pick up the phone and talk to her and get off work early to spend cherished time with her. Now that Bobby Meyer is looking after BJ, you can understand how upset Mrs. Jones was when the picture came out in the paper of Bobby
and her unmarried.
Mrs. Meyer.
He's twisting everything around, but he's making it.
You will have your chance. Anything else to add, Mr. Baldwin?
Just my conviction. Lucy Jones is a fine, caring woman who loves her stepdaughter.
Thank you. You're excused.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Let's see now. Mr. Duke Lavery.
Oh, excuse me. Can I? Your Honor, if you please, I'd like to speak next. I have some rather pressing matters back at headquarters.
All right with you, Mr. Lavery?
Perfectly all right, sir.
Thank you. Sit down, Commissioner. How long have you known Mrs. Meyer?
Roughly about 7 to 8 years. During that time, I have found Bobby to be a very loving and caring nurse, a person who I feel can accept a lot of responsibility. As a matter of fact, my ex-wife, Mrs. Lavery, and I often leave our child, Robin, to stay with Bobby for extended periods of time. And Robin is always happy to stay there longer. She really does love it over there.
How well do you know Dr. Tony Jones?
Very well. I was very close to his younger brother, Frisco, who was recently deceased.
Tragic, yes, I heard about that.
Frisco and his wife shared an apartment at the Brownstone, as did Dr. Jones and his wife, Tanya. Tony's relationship with Bobby was one that I always felt was based on very solid trust. Otherwise, he would never have written into his divorce agreement that Bobby be given Barbara Jean to care for, an agreement which, so far, is still unsigned.
Judge Wyler, could I just say something?
Mrs. Jones, you'll have your turn. Anything else to add, Commissioner?
Only that I feel Bobby to be totally trustworthy and could offer Barbara Jean a lot of love.
Thank you. Mr. Lavery.
The first indication that we had that anything was wrong with the Joneses' marriage, Dr. Jones, Tony, he moved out of his home and took the little baby, Barbara Jean, with him. He took an apartment at the Brownstone, and from that time on, Bobby took very good care of the child, Barbara Jean.
Is that right, Mrs. Meyer?
Yes, it is, Your Honor. I took time off from the hospital to look after BJ, and one of us from the Brownstone was always with her.
How about that story in yesterday's paper concerning Mrs. Meyer's alleged love life? Does that fit with what you know of Bobby Meyer?
No, not in the least, Your Honor. No. I used to be chief of police of the city and had to deal with the press on a regular basis. And obviously, these reporters, they'll sensationalize anything just to get a front page story.
So you think it was a setup? Mrs. Meyer in a robe with Mr. Howard in an apartment that Mr. Howard's wife didn't know about?
I don't know what happened there, but I do know that Tony Jones has a great deal of respect for this lady and would definitely want her to look after his daughter.
You may step down. This is Lucy Jones. You come up here.
Well, when I learned that Tony's first wife, Tanya, had wanted to establish a daycare center, I thought it was a perfect way to pay tribute to her memory and continue her work.
You didn't plan the daycare center. It wasn't your
idea. Mrs. Meyer, I'll have no more outbursts in this court. Go on, Mrs. Jones.
Thank you. Well, it was not my idea, but I did get the hospital behind the daycare center, and I started raising money from all sorts of different sources, and I got the builders and the permits, and we got that daycare center established.
Now, I've read all the reports from the social welfare people. I just have one question for you. What happened the day that Barbara Jean swallowed the nail polish remover while you were looking after her?
Your Honor, I have to tell you that had to be the blackest day in my life. We came so close to
losing that wonderful little girl just because of my stupidity.
Tell me about it.
Well, I had a friend over, a personal friend that was having a lot of problems with a man that she was thinking about marrying, that she really wanted to marry, and it wasn't working, so she was very emotional, and we were in this intense conversation. And BJ was just all over the place, you know, like two-year-olds can do, and it just happened.
You must have been terrified.
Oh, I was crazy. I was nuts. I grabbed BJ, I grabbed the bottle of poison, and I took to the hospital so they'd know right away what she had swallowed, and it's okay because she's all right now, but, Your Honor, I still have the most horrible nightmares about that.
Thank you. You may step down now.
Thank you.
Mrs. Meyer.
Your Honor, I think that the most important point for Barbara Jean's welfare is the fact that Tony and Lucy Jones are going through an extremely hostile divorce right now, and as a result of that, Tony has stipulated in his will, should anything happen to him, that I am the one that he wants to be appointed BJ's legal guardian.
Now, that's been pointed out. However, the court has to weigh many other factors in the balance. For example, the only word is lurid, picture and story in yesterday's paper, describing a love nest that you share with a prominent political figure.
Just nailed right against the wall.
Mm-hmm. Your Honor, it's not a love nest. Mr. Howard and I are very close personal friends, but we are not and have never been lovers.
Was the photograph a fake?
Well, no, it wasn't a fake. It was accurate, but it didn't help the whole story. We had an accident.
What kind of accident?
Clothes. Well, it had to do with whipping cream. We were making dessert.
Don't punish yourself further by trying to explain the inexplicable. 10 minutes recess, after which I'll render my decision. Clerk, please ask Mrs. Keith to bring the child in. Well, I hate to tell you this, but it seems to me that neither one of you has a very good case. Bobby Meyer, Lucy Jones, neither of you has a real home to bring Barbara Jean back to. Mrs. Meyer may be more than Mrs. Jones, but you're both married women separated from your husbands. You've both demonstrated varying levels of irresponsibility that make me fear for this child's welfare. But we're under the gun here. Child's father seriously, perhaps terminally ill. Until he recovers, God willing, I'm not going to place this child with either one of you. Instead, I'm going to put her into a foster home.
Why?
You can't do that.
Get
away.
What
is it,
Your Honor. I have a home and a husband and a daughter of my own. We make a steady income, and I would like to volunteer to be Barbara Jean's foster mother, please.